chicken is key. Oh my gosh. There it is.
Is it capo one?
Capo one.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anything can happen. It's up to luck and our imagination. Anything can happen. Let's jump the track and guess our destination. Well, I like to be prepared, and when I can't be, I get scared. But you make me sure anything can happen. Anything can happen. Anything can happen. Anything can happen. Well, like to be prepared, and after everything we've shared, you make me sure. You make me sure. You make me sure. Thank you. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you, Ben, for the introduction. Thank you, Jeff, for joining me. I'm really thrilled to have this chance to share this personal music that I've been working on for the last 3 years. This EP is based off of 3 years of daily journaling and sketching in spiral-bound notebooks. It was really challenging after rolling off to the show to figure out how to express myself, because I had been expressing myself through a major animated television show for 8 years, or really 10 years, because through Adventure Time 2, and I really had to break everything all the way down and build it back up from scratch. And one of the hardest things to do after that time was nothing, because I had been doing so much work, and every day was so packed, and so. One of the early songs I wrote was after a day where I challenged myself like a job to do absolutely nothing, and it was really harder than any job that I had done, because it was so unfamiliar. So this is a song called Good Morning Afternoon. Good morning afternoon, good morning afternoon. I didn't think that I'd be seeing you so soon. Wasn't it just 11, half a minute ago? I thought the day was moving slow, I thought the day was moving. Wasn't it just 11, half a minute ago? I thought the day was moving slow. Good morning afternoon, good morning afternoon. I didn't think that I'd be seeing you so soon. Wasn't it just 11, half a minute ago? I thought the day was moving slow, I thought the day was moving slow. Just 11, half a minute ago. I thought the day was moving slow. This next song, this is the first song on Spiral Bound. I brought this song to Jeff. I really cannot thank Jeff enough. he has really been encouraging me to share. I did not know if I'd ever share these songs. And I had been writing them, and it had been so healing for me personally to be working on them. But I brought the demos to you, and this was a song where I wasn't sure if it was going to be on or not. It's a song called Sweet Time. And when you had heard it, you said, oh, we have to do this one.
Yeah. We definitely needed this one. Just everybody in general.
Thank you. One of the things that was challenging about slowing down, you know, especially here, you know, I had so much momentum, and everyone was like, it's so important to build off all of this momentum, but I just needed to rest, I didn't know what to do, So I was writing this song around this, I'll get to that other song later. Around the same time as a different song that was sort of my love letter to parting ways with the show. And this was like the bright side of that coin. So this song is called Sweet Time. Everybody's heading somewhere, and they wanna get there faster, but I'm taking my sweet time. I used to be in such a hurry, so much, so quick, so sick with worry. Now I'm taking my sweet time. Need to solve the maze. I'll stretch like a shadow and fade like the haze. I'll work all day, but I won't deliver. I'll grow like a tree in the LA River. Everybody's selling something, looking for the highest bidder, but a shadow and fade like the haze. I'll work all day, but I won't deliver. I'll grow like a tree in the LA River. Everybody's selling something, looking for the highest bidder, but I'm taking my sweet time. 'Cause everything and someone else telling me what matters, so I'm taking my sweet time. I'm taking my sweet time. So around the time that I was working on that, one of the things I loved to do around then, I was heading over to Topanga a lot, and I went and stayed in a canned ham trailer for a while. It was like a bright blue canned ham trailer with a dog that liked to run inside when I left the door open. I was not familiar with whose dog this was. And sometimes he'd be like staring in the window at me. And I was working on these songs, and at the same time I was working on a song for the Fiona and Cake special, which Adam Muto had reached out to me and described to me this sequence. It was like, oh, this is going to be Simon Petrikov. He's left his magic behind. He's left the crown behind, and he's healthy again. But now he feels like he doesn't know his place in this world, that's this eccentric, magical world. And he was like, oh, do you feel like that's something that you could find, a song in, that you could find relatable? I said, oh, yes. Yes, I think I have something to say about that. So it was really exciting to get a chance to reflect on getting to be a part of Adventure Time, getting a chance to do Steven, and just the roller coaster of all of it, looking back on it with all this new perspective of trying to be a healthy person. And so I wrote the song, which is called Part of the Madness. Does somebody jump for joy? Does somebody cry? Now that I'm not part of that sadness. Does somebody want me now? Now that I can't fly. Now that I'm not part of the madness. Part of the madness. Part of the madness. Part of the madness. Laughter and screams seem to echo faintly. I can still hear them around. Somewhere the roller coaster climbs and dives while I've got my feet on the ground. Aren't I so much better now that I'm just a normal guy? Now that I'm not. Now that I'm. Now that I'm not part of the sadness, part of the badness, part of the radness, part of the madness. So this next song, this was another one that we really did a lot of different versions of this particular song for Spiral Bound, and I was a little unsure about it because it was so specific. A lot of the others are fairly open to interpretation, but one of the things I found as I did these 3 years of journaling, and I kind of broke everything down to build it back up again, is I just tried to return to why I wanted to be a creative person in the first place. And it got me to thinking about being a very, very little child. I went to a really kind of eclectic hippie preschool in Adams Morgan, D.C. I was talking recently, I had a friend who we are still occasionally in touch. We went to preschool together. He ended up moving to New Orleans and joining a group of anarchists who like were dumpster diving and cooking meals for the unhoused. And I was on the phone with him during pandemic, and he was like, I think I was radicalized by our preschool. And I was like, I think I was too. I really think that that's where it came from. And I felt so lucky to grow up in this very specific place. If you've ever been to Adams Morgan, there's these vibrant murals everywhere. It was just a really artistic place to be. So this song is called Adams Morgan 1991. My dad's a graphic designer. He had an office in Adams Morgan, so I was always in and out of his office watching people do design. And these are just some of my most formative memories.
Blackberries growing on a chain link fence. Cool breezes blowing through an open door. Sidewalks are cracking in the midday sun. Adams Morgan, 1991. Cold pizza waiting in the kitchen fridge. Blue pilly carpet on an endless floor. Warm light is streaming where the children run. Adams Morgan, 1991. Cows ride bicycles across the sky. And Madam's watching us from up on high. Down Calorama with an ice cream cone. Fine office markers that I shouldn't touch. Dad's new computer looks like so much fun. Adams Morgan, 1991. Scooby Gang, wild secret garden with the chlorine pool, long row house shadows when the day is done. Adams Morgan, 1991. Long children's faces when the day is done. Adams Morgan, 1991.
We try. Thank you so much. I know that it's sort of not the first time that I've mined my childhood for inspiration for songs. And one of the other songs that really came from a childhood memory was a song called Everything Stays, which I wrote for Adventure Time. Also a request from Adam. So Everything Stays was inspired by when I was very young, I had this little black rabbit stuffed animal that I absolutely loved, and I lost track of it for a while, and then one day I found it in the garden, and it was on its back, and its belly was facing up, and the sun had faded it, so it now had like a white belly, even though it was this little black rabbit. And it was the first time I realized that even if you leave something alone, it'll change. It'll change without you, whether you know it's changing or not. And that was just, it was like baby's first existential meltdown. I've thought about this a lot. I actually ended up realizing about halfway into the Steven Universe movie that I was still obsessing about this rabbit and just carrying so much guilt. And one of the things that I noticed journaling for 3 years, like in returning to this song, some of the songs I had written before, is just that I should cut myself a break for doing this when I was five. that it's unhealthy to feel so bad about that every day to this day. And so, you know, I've been learning to be a little kinder to myself in that regard. But so this is a song called Everything Stays. Let's go in the garden. You'll find something waiting right there where you left it, lying upside down. When you finally find it, you'll see how it's faded. The underside is lighter when you turn it around. Everything stays right where you left it. Everything stays, but it still changes ever so slightly, daily and nightly, in little ways.
changes ever so slightly, daily and nightly, in little ways, when everything stays ever so slightly, daily and nightly, in little ways, when everything stays.
Continuing with this capo and this theme, there's another song that Adam called me up and asked me to write another song, I'm realizing that I always do. But this one was really special. He was asking me to write a song for the Adventure Time finale at the time, and so. It was a wild time to get this request. I was moving. I was just going through a lot of change, but at the same time, I was deep into Steven Universe at that time, and I was missing working on Adventure Time. It was some of the happiest times of my life. Was being there, being a storyboard partner with Adam, and I had so many memories of coming in and drawing all day and how exciting it was. So I wanted to write a song to celebrate that feeling, but at the same time, I also wanted to write a song to celebrate the show itself and also animation. So I wrote this song called Time Adventure, which is about those memories and how they always exist in the past. But it's also about animation itself, because in animation, every drawing you see on screen exists, but the only way to experience it is to let it go, to move through time and let each drawing go as soon as it appears in order to experience the effect, the illusion of animation. And so I was trying to think about life in that way, that all of those moments, if they did exist, would still have to pass in order to be an experience. So this is a song called Time Adventure. Time is an illusion that helps things make sense. So we're always living in the present tense. It seems unforgiving when a good thing ends, 'cause you and I will always be back then. 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 Singing will happen, happening happened. Will happen, happening happened. And there we are again and again. 'Cause you and I will always be back then. 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 If there was some amazing force outside of time to take us back to where we were and hang each moment up like pictures on the wall inside a billion tiny frames so that we could see it all, look like will happen, happening happened. Will happen, happening happened. And there we are again and again. 'Cause you and I will always be back then. You and I will always be back then. You and I will always be back then. That's why you and I will always be best friends. Thank you. originally that song was going to be called See You in Reruns. But I thought that the time adventure covered even more ground than that. Let's see. So this is another song from Spiral Bound. Going back in time, you know, digging through sort of past regrets, I actually brought back a song I had written previously, much, much earlier. This was actually written on uke before I was learning guitar. It was wild recording this and returning to it. I actually didn't realize I was still, that there was so much unresolved about this particular memory surrounding the song that I had written, and I'm really grateful that I did, because I needed to dredge it back up and look at it and really figure it out so I could move forward. This is a song, you know, I don't know if any of you can relate to that kind of thing, but this is a song called I Didn't Mean To from Spiral Bound.
What am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to do? Normally I just ask you, but we haven't spoken. Would you say what you always say? It's better if you tell the truth. But look at what the truth has done. Your heart is broken, your heart is broken, and what good is? I didn't mean to. When I see you looking like you do, what good is? I didn't mean to. When I see you looking like you do, oh, 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 I didn't mean to. I didn't mean to. Oh, 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 I didn't mean to. I didn't mean to.
This next song was probably the most unusual songwriting experience I ever had. The melody was written by Steven Universe composers Ivy and Sirashu. It started as an instrumental song that was playing over Steven Universe's credits. And there was just a little snippet of it, and they asked if I would write lyrics and sing vocals on it. And I don't think I would have done it myself if they hadn't asked me to. It was really generous of them, but the strange thing about it was we wrote it like 15 seconds at a time over like 6 years. we only had the very beginning, so I wrote for the very beginning, and then like 2 years later we were on to the next piece of the song, so I wrote that piece of the song. And at the very beginning I thought, oh, this song will be fun, you know, it's like, it seems kind of like a love song, but secretly it's like about these aliens and they just don't know how humans work, and it's like a secret sci-fi song. And then like when we got to the middle I was like, oh no, like that's not what this is about at all. You know, it's like I was like really struggling, and the song became about that. And then when we finished it years later, I had just sort of realized so much about myself and about what Steven Universe was really about, and you know, so Love Like You as a whole song was just this incredible experience from start to finish. And then there's like an extra, I think not like the one that's online, but there's a version a final version towards the end of the show where you repeats over and over and over again. They layered all these versions of it. And I was like, when they sent it to me, I was just like sobbing and sobbing because the finality of it was so intense. And it was so beautiful. You did these gorgeous, gorgeous strings over it. So yeah, I'd love to play that for you all. And I'm just so thrilled that it's a song that's been resonating. Thank you. If I could begin to be half of what you think of me, would do about anything, I would even learn how to love. When I see the way you act, wondering if I'm coming back, I would do about anything, I would even learn how to love like you. Think you're so good, and I'm nothing like you. Look at you go, I just adore you. I wish that I knew what makes you think I'm so special. If I could begin to do something that does right by you, I would do about anything, I would even learn how. When I see the way you look, shaken by how long it took, I would do about anything, I would even learn how to love like you. So much. Thank you.
I love you, Rebecca.
Thank you. thanks. This is the final song from our set. It's also the final song on Spiral Bound. I originally wrote this song with the dreams of it being like a big jam band song, where at the end of a concert I could go, so and so on keys, and so, you know, like, you know, Jeff Liu on the bass, you know, and obviously Jeff Ball on violin, and that was my like quiet dream. This is a pretty intimate small concert, but I'm gonna do it anyway. I'm gonna do it as best I can. And then when I brought this to you, with that ambition, you had a vision. Jeff had a vision for it of kind of bringing in like a comedy anime 2000s OST vibe, kind of Azumanga Daioh energy to it, and I was like, yes, let's do it. All right, so this is called My Own Way to the End. Something's up ahead, just around the bend. I remember when I felt just a little bit younger than our friends. But they've gone on ahead, and I've been left behind. That's fine, I'll just find my own way to the end. Thank you. joining us at Nucleus. Thank you, Gallery Nucleus. I haven't really done concerts, so Jeff was like, get ready in case people want an encore. So it's a 10-year anniversary of Stephen coming out today. Which is so wild to me, and I was digging through a bunch of my just really old stuff recently, and I was chatting with Ian and with some friends about there was this song that's like this lost song, and we were chatting about how it's like it's such a shame you never recorded that, and I couldn't remember it. There was a board that never got produced that was between the pilot and the show, and there was a song in that episode which when I was pitching the show. I performed it in front of, it was like we had this giant, terrifying meeting, and all of us were sitting waiting to go in. There were like a bunch of international executives, and it was right at the moment where all these shows hung in the balance. So it was like Uncle Grandpa, Over the Garden Wall, Clarence, OKKO, and Stephen were all, it was, we were, basically all of us creators were like sitting on a bench. Pat was in a full Wirt costume. Pete Browngart, creative Uncle Grandpa, had these like rainbow suspenders on. It was like we were all just like stone faced, like ready to go in, and it's just like this could make or break the show. And I was sitting there with my little banjo ukulele, and when I went in, I showed this little piece of this board, and I sang this song, and later when the show got greenlit, this may or may not have been the reason that it was, but the song is like totally lost to time. I couldn't remember it at all. It was about Stephen wanting to be a meatball sandwich. And then recently when I was going through all these old storyboards, I found the thumbs, and the thumbs had the lyrics written on them. And I was like, oh my gosh, once I could read it, I was like, yes, I remember it. I burst into the house. I was like, Ian, I remember the song. I was like, I remember how it goes. I pulled out the guitar and I played it really quick. So I'll play it for you. I'll play it for you. This is the song that may or may not. So it went. If I were a meatball sub, I'd eat myself. If I were a leftover, I'd heat myself. Then I'd be as good as new. I'd feel as good as I do when I'm washing a car out here with you. It was with Greg. If I were at a restaurant, I'd seat myself, and I'd get a meatball sub to treat myself. Everyone would be grossed out, because I'm a meatball sub that's eating another meatball sub. But I guess that's okay. I don't care what other meatball subs may say. All the other subs are always calling out, 'cause I walk around with my meatballs falling out. With my meatballs falling out. Yes, that's what did it. Okay, I think I could do one more. Let me give it a try. One of the things I was reflecting on with Adam's work in 1991, there's this line about Madam is watching us from up on high. There's a bar called Madam's Organ in Adam's Morgan. It's Madam's Organ. And there's a giant mural of this, please look it up, it's this very, very voluptuous, vibrantly redheaded lady with Madam's Organ written here that I just had a... I'm glad to have had access to as a very young child. It had a really big impact on me, and I think really formative. I think the earliest Rose Quartz thoughts probably trace all the way back to this. Anyway, I thought it was pretty funny. Seeing this song like circulating now and just having this, you know, really sort of personal memory of this particular mural. So, let's do Giant Woman. All I wanna do is help you turn into a giant woman, a giant woman. All I wanna be is someone who gets to see a giant woman. All I wanna do is help you turn into a giant woman, a giant woman. All I wanna be is someone who gets to see a giant woman. Oh, I know it'll be great, and I just can't wait to see the person you are together. If you give it a chance, you could do a huge dance, because you are a giant woman. You might even like being together, and if you don't, it won't be forever. But if it were me, I'd really wanna be a giant woman, a giant woman. All I wanna do is help you turn into a giant woman.